All right. So first off, good afternoon, everybody from Camp Arifjan, Kuwait. We want to thank you for giving us this opportunity. I know for time purposes, we're low, so I will be very brief. Again, I'm Major Clarence Black, the RSID Forward Public Affairs Officer here at Camp Arifjan. And today we're going to take you through our ACFT or Army Combat Fitness Test. Now, for you all on the race team, if you think back to 2018 when you won the Daytona 500, think about how good that felt. All of the hours of training and preparation all to culminate on probably what was your best day. For us, it's different. When we train, we're training for combat, and that's arguably our worst day. It's not something any of us ever want to do. Some of us have done it, but that's our worst day. So we train hard so that we can survive and thrive in our worst day ever. So we're going to take you through the Army Combat Fitness Test, not the whole test, but just a few events. And then we're going to also show you the combat application. To do that today, I'm joined by two of the Army's finest first sergeants. First Sergeant Patrick Pitts from the Civil Affairs Support Detachment. Let me introduce First Sergeant Pitts. First Sergeant Pitts is going to walk you through the event, kind of tell you why we're doing it. And then I want to introduce you to First Sergeant Christopher Williams. So I know you're from Welcome, North Carolina, Austin. Sergeant Pitts, tell them where you're from.
First Sergeant Williams. And I'm from Magnolia, North Carolina.
Awesome.
All right. So with that, I'm going to turn it over to these awesome first sergeants who will walk you through the ACFT and then also the combat application. First Sergeant Pitts.
Hey, how's it going today? Over here, we have the medium deadlift. It's going to be demonstrated by Shabonda Hill. All right. The medium deadlift consists of three phases, the preparatory, the upward movement, and the downward movement. And it simulates lifting equipment and soldiers for litter carries. So go ahead and demonstrate. And she'll do that for a maximum of three times. All right. And then the next event is our standing power throw. The standing power throw demonstrates explosive power, flexibility, and dynamic balance. Explosive power contributes to tasks requiring quick, explosive movements to maneuver equipment and personnel. So go ahead and demonstrate. We'll get a couple of practice evolutions. Okay. And then.
So the combat application behind the deadlift is to extract the soldier on the litter. So we have Sergeant Gibbons, who's going to be the lead man on my litter. Sergeant Gibbons, go and demonstrate, extract it. Demonstrate extracting the soldier on a litter, please.
1, 2, 3, 1. One, two, three, go.
And that's the whole purpose of the litter carry.
All right, so our next demonstration will be Staff Sergeant Bakken doing a sprint drag carry. What he's going to do is he's going to lay prone on the ground. Go ahead, Sergeant Bach. And on the command go, he's going to jump to his feet and sprint 25 meters as fast as he can and back. And then once he returns, he's going to pick up a 90-pound sled and drag it down and back. And then he'll do a lateral movement down and back. And then he'll pick up two 40-pound kettlebells down and back. And finally, he'll sprint down and back to finish 250 meters total. You ready, Sergeant Bakken? Go.
I wanted to see the pool.
Sprint drag carry measures muscular power, endurance, and strength and anaerobic capacity, which are needed to accomplish high-intensity combat tasks that last from a few seconds to several minutes.
I'm going to introduce Sergeant Gibbons and Sergeant Johnson. They're going to demonstrate the combat applications to sprint drag carry. So the combat application to stand track and carry is to carry an injured casualty from out of the combat zone into safety in order to receive tactical casual care. So Sergeant Gibbons is going to be my casualty. And Sergeant Johnson is going to be the person that's going to retrieve him and bring him back to safety.
You good right there, Sergeant Gibbons?
Just go get him and drag him back. Hey. And you clear. So yeah. For the standing power jump, the whole purpose, the combat application behind the standing power jump is to get your equipment across a wall. So I got my introduced Specialist Hoot and Specialist Hackford. They're gonna be my demonstrators as Specialist Hoot tosses the equipment, which is gonna be this A-bag to Specialist Hackford over the wall. Next, first off, bits.
All right, next we're going to do the hand release push-ups, which demonstrates pushing away from a enemy personnel in a combat situation or pushing a vehicle or anything else you might need this movement for. So on the command go, he's going to go ahead and push up all the way, go, down, and then he's going to put his hands out to the side and return them and go again.
Yeah, I
have to do that normally. Yeah, that's the hand release push-up.
And the combat application behind the hand release push-up is when you're in man-to-man contact, is in order to push your opponent away whenever you are into this man-to-man contact. Sorry, first on pits?
Yes. Which one we have now?
Yep. All right. So, hey, again, that was just a few of the events for the ACFT. I want to thank you all for joining us and for allowing us to demonstrate that for you. Again, all the things that we train to do is designed for our worst day ever, but it's so that we can survive, so that we can thrive in combat, so that we can save our buddies' lives, and so that we can continue to win America's wars. Depending on any questions, thanks for joining us.
Thank you.
All right, Major Black, thank you very much. Let's turn it over to the folks down at Richard Childress Racing. I see Austin Dillon with his team there. And Austin, that was a very impressive demonstration there, to say the least.
Yeah, it was awesome to see a lot of the workouts applied to what they do. And when we get in the gym and pit stop practice, all these guys are doing similar things to kind of make their job better, be best they can be at their job. But thank you guys for putting on a show. We don't have quite the equipment right now up here that you guys have, but we're going to put on our best workout. Jackson here is our trainer, and he can kind of tell you, walk everybody through what the pit crew are going to do today.
All right. Sounds good.
All right.
Can we move the
– Yeah, so I'm going to pick it up.
So, like Austin said, my name is Jackson. I'm the trainer here at Mr. Children's Racing.
Paul, you want to start us off?
So,
I'll hold it.
I can hold it. So, just like y'all stated, NASCAR is a very explosive movement. It's a very explosive sport. Everything is going to happen between 10 and 13 seconds. So Paul is our tire carrier here at Richard Childress Racing. Paul is going to demonstrate an eccentric loaded box squat. He's going to get a three count down. He's going to release the dumbbells and go into a box squat. This is all explosive power. This is being as quick from point A to point B as possible. So Paul, 3, 2, 1. Good. So he'll perform three of these plyometric drills. Usually we would superset this with a strength component. 1, 2, 3. Good. Last one, Paul. 3, 2, 1. Good.
Nice.
So that is an eccentric loaded box jump. The next person we're going to go to is Ernie, our Jackman, right here. As you can see. Yeah, can you hold this?
Yep.
One of the biggest components for a Jackman is running around the car. So as we can demonstrate with Ernie, he is going to do a split squat for speed, training type 2 muscle fibers. Up quick. Fast up. Good. Running around the car is very important to make up time lost. And a split squat is a very good application to a real life sprint position. Good. The next person, Josh Thomas, front changer. Like I said, everything we do is in increments of 10 to 13 seconds. On top of
it. Oh, on top?
On top of
it. Oh, yeah. Straight leg.
Let's go. So Josh is going to do a 7-second flutter kick. Like I said, training type 2 muscle fibers, our quick twitch muscle fibers. All right. Ready, Josh? Ready? Go. Quick, 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 quick. Fast, fast, fast. 3, 2, 1.
All right, so explain why we do everything fast, because the pit stops, the duration's really short.
Yeah, so in pit stops, we are training the anaerobic system. Anaerobic system is anything around 10 to 12 seconds. We are not conditioning. We are doing straight explosive power movements, and everything you can see here is a plyometric or an explosive movement to train us to be faster off the jump, faster out of a kneeling position. So now we're going to go to Ethan, our rear changer. Ethan is going to perform a lateral box jump. He's going to jump out off one leg, back towards the box on two, and then jump into a box jump. So he's going to go out, face, jump.
Yep.
All right, ready? Nice. Two more. Good. As a rear changer, Ethan has to get up from his kneeling position and change positions as fast as possible to go the other direction around the car. So Ethan will do 3 each side. Always training both sides of the body. One more. Good. And last, Voss, our gas man. The gas man carries a 96-pound fluid can on one side of his body. So what we're doing here with a suitcase carry is training Voss to carry a load on one side of his body while maintaining a rigid position on the other, training his obliques. So Voss will carry the weight off the hip and walk, just like a farmer's carry. He'll walk 10 yards, switch hands, and go the other direction. Switch. Like I said, this is training Voss to stay upright, rigid, in a tight core as he carries a gas can. It's all on one side of the body. So he has to stay stable and not allow the fluid weight of the gas can to move his position during a pit stop. So that is everything we have in here. I wish we could show you these exercises as they correspond to the car, but obviously we don't have a car up here with us right now. But thank you for having our time and showing us what y'all do. That's it's awesome. It's very cool to watch. I'm hoping anything we can do in here is just as cool for y'all. So I'd like to say thank y'all.
Yep, yeah. Everybody. Appreciate thank you guys for what you do. Yeah. Ready? All right, Doug.
Doug, you're muted.
We were. All right, you still on? Doug muted.
Mr. Rice, yeah. You're muted.
Doug is still muted.
All right, let's do this one more time. Austin, did you and your group have questions for Major Black and his team?
We say that again, Doug.
I said, did you guys have a little bit of time for some questions for Major Black and his team?
Yeah, anything, ask away. Probably a good question to why I didn't do a workout.
Hey, Austin, Major Black. I think my biggest question is how much would you say or what percentage of your training is dedicated to team building in or outside of your season?
That's actually a great question. Just the other week, I was able to – we meet different people along the way at the tracks. We love having military personnel out of the track, and I made friends with a SEAL a while back, Sean Murphy, and I actually had Sean come up and do a team building week with our guys. So we spent half our days with Sean, and then we did our pit stop practice, and we reconvened with Sean, and we kind of went over all the team building stuff that he was successful with in the Navy, and we just kind of as a group work on whatever we need to do to become better as a team. Obviously, a full race is not won unless we all do our jobs properly. It takes each and every one of us. I mean, it can come down to, fractions of a second at the racetrack. For these guys, a pit stop, we lose a tenth. It's like 100, 200 yards on the racetrack. It's a long, long time. And then, mistakes are made throughout, but as a team, if we stick together and we kind of minimize those mistakes, we have a good shot of being where we need to be at the end of the race. So the team building part of it is huge for us, and I think it was good for our team. These guys can attest to it. Just the other week, we actually pushed – we did an eight-mile hike together carrying our sandbag selves is what we called it. We had a sandbag that we had to carry, and by the end of the week, we were able to drop our sandbags as a group, and we pushed our car back to the shop for the last mile.
Awesome. Nice. Any more questions?
Little hot out here.
I guarantee it. Yeah. You guys get inside. Get some AC. A little cooler area.
Hey, gladly. Listen, we wanna thank you again on behalf of US Arsent for having us, and man, best of luck to you. And in the rest of your season, we'll be rooting for you.
Thank you, guys. Thanks for putting on the demonstration. Thank you for all your work. Thank you for serving.
Thank you.
Well, Austin, that was pretty special. I know that you and your team have a great appreciation for all things military. And to watch these people working out half a world away, that's a great way to kick off your day.
It is. It's awesome to see what everyone's doing overseas and the effort that's going in. And we love our military men and women in NASCAR. And anytime you guys get back to the stateside, we got to get you out of the track. So any way we can.
Well, I want to thank everybody.
We will definitely take you up on it.
Perfect.
All right. I want to thank everybody here at Charlotte Motor Speedway for setting this event up as part of Mission 600. Thanks to Austin Dillon and his team being part of the Coca-Cola Racing family and pulling this off today. And Austin, congrats to you and your team. Nice start this year, 11th in points and heading down to Darlington this weekend.
Yeah, thank you. We've had a pretty solid start. We go get another top 10 this weekend. We'll be 50% on top 10s this year, which is a pretty good feat. But we want to not lock ourselves in. A lot of people are winning right now, and the spots are closing up for the playoffs. So need to get that win, and this weekend's a good place to do it. We got a lot of pit stops, long race. It's been a good one for us. Finished second last year, pretty close. So looking forward to Darlington.
Major Clarence Austin, Black, thank you. Thank you to U.S. Army Central Station there in Kuwait. Every day, we appreciate everything you do to allow Austin Dillon and his team and all of us to enjoy what we get to do here.
Thank you.
Major, are you getting ready to say something?
No, I was just going to say, in 2021, fortunately, U.S. Army Central has got a presence on social media. We'd appreciate it if you follow us, and we'll do the same and follow you, my friend.
All right. What is it? U.S. Army Central?
U.S. Army Central.
All right.
Also known as U.S. Arsent.
I got that covered.
All right.
All right. Well, thanks everyone today for joining in on this international version of Mission 600. Take care. Thank you very much.